There's a rumor they buried a bunch of other things in the desert with all those old ET games. No, for real. Like the good episode of Spacebar, they're all buried there, in case you were wondering. Spacebar. I'm Nick Gregorio. Welcome to the Bar in the Stars. Today we're talking games that fell flat, disappointed, and straight up sucked. There's a lot of contenders, but ultimately, what's the most disappointing video game you've ever played? And I want to start with you, Phil Arrigo.
All right, for me, Marvel vs. Capcom 3. That game, it's gorgeous. It's got a great
it's
roster.
So cool. This ranks pretty high with me too.
And I remember seeing the trailer, seeing the gameplay, and I was like, this thing's gonna be a fucking banger. And I got it home, and I was like, what is happening here? I now know how elderly people feel when they watch children play video games. I'm like, wait, what? How did I would play against like people who didn't play fighting games?
That's like after. It's called like colors of the game.
Just yeah, pfft. it's blurring all over the place. Yeah, you're getting 174 hit combos, and I'm just like, cool, okay. What's the tag system? What's
am I juggling? Was he juggling me? We're all up in the. You guys haven't played this? Cool.
It's a fighting game.
Yeah, okay,
I don't really play fighting.
But you guys didn't. Marvel vs. Capcom 2? That was fun.
Played in the arcades.
But okay. Here's the thing. Marvel vs. Capcom 2, sure, maybe wasn't balanced, and maybe all the sprites, they kind of yanked them from different games. You knew what was going on. It kind of had the feel of like Street Fighter.
It was more Street Fighter than it was
steroids.
Weird.
This new one, it starts off with these like sweeping cinematic, and you're like, oh, this is going to be good. And then all of a sudden, when you start pushing buttons, like, the special moves happen automatically, and the easy mode is that like new people can play as. I got schooled by people who never played fighting games before.
Yeah.
And it was you just like spin, move, what, and then you go play online. I'm like, hold on, let me take this online. You make one wrong move,
dude,
and your 98 hit combo done. You set the controller down and go take a bath.
I leveled up this kid in Mexico City. So, I mean, he beat me like 100 times in a row. And I just kept trying like little giants in it. I was like, I just need one win, but nah, never happened. All right, Chloe, what about you? Most disappointing game?
Most disappointing game, I would say, would be Alan Wake. This game was in development for probably, I think it's about a decade, and people were so freaking excited about this game. It looked so good, right? The character looked, the character.
But wasn't it like a, it wasn't like a storybook that was a game?
It was, right? Well, it was a story game, but it was a first-person shooter, action-adventure kind of thing. But it all took place in the same fucking setting. It's a forest, right? You walk around a dark forest. Ooh, spooky goat guys, and then you hit them with the
goat
flashlight.
Goat ghost guys.
Wait, ghost guys?
Ghost guys.
Scary.
They're
ghost.
Like shadow guys, and they come out, and then you hit them with the flashlight to bring down their shield and you shoot them. But all of the combat's exactly the same, right?
That sounds awful.
It's super boring. The game shows you when there's a bad guy, right? It's like, oh, it goes into slow motion every time a bad guy comes out. Here's a bad guy, and then you hit him. It was.
Is that why it goes into slow motion every time Nick shows up?
Because you're bad. It was good.
You're not a good guy.
All right, Elliot.
So who's
Tia Carrera?
Wait,
but I'm not done.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm still mad. Okay, so the game, its story, you don't even know what the fucking story is.
What is the story?
You don't know, because at the end, basically you have to collect pages to understand what's happening in this. It's supposed to be like Twin Peaks-y Stephen King, and you get to the end and they're like, here's the story, but if you don't collect enough pages, it doesn't make any sense. It's really frustrating.
Did you collect all the pages?
No.
I
collected most of the thermoses, by the way, which is another stupid mechanic
that
you have
never,
to collect. You go out of your way to collect thermoses.
If I was making a Cooper the Video Game, you would collect thermoses. Like, not.
He's like, oh, Muppet Babies? This is a World War II one?
So, look.
Collection of thermoses. Let's see what Elliot has. What's your pick for most disappointing game?
The earliest one I remember is Christmas 1997, I think, was the year I got Turok Dinosaur Hunter.
Oh, Turok! Sorry.
And
oh, wow.
Turok.
I got Turok and South Park the video game at the same time.
Nintendo 64.
And quickly realized that South Park the video game was a reskinned version of Turok. So I literally had the same game twice.
Oh,
but
no.
One was a shitty reskin with South Park characters.
That's not true. This was the game with the turkeys, right? The
Thanksgiving. Yeah. That was Turok, but with the South Park skins put on it.
But I mean, it still gave you that like South Park-y goodness.
No, they had like four sound bites.
Was it really Turok? Am I going crazy? I don't recall that at all.
Nah, it was the same.
I mean, all those
I trust Elliot.
I think I just got really disappointed.
They all kind of looked the same. They were like 3D model, low res textures, and
there's only so much they could do.
Yeah,
you know? They didn't have the control scheme. You didn't have enough buttons.
It's 97.
I mean,
even if it literally wasn't a reskin,
it was like I think
99?
It was like 2000.
Well.
Well, because it was on N64. Both of them were on Turok N64.
So the N64 launched in 97. And
well, they made a Turok. I think it was Turok 2.
Turok 2
was the one
that's
that was
when South Park came
yeah.
out.
So yeah, that kind of sucked. Could have gotten a second game that was
any,
actually
any
unique.
More recent titles or?
People are going to hate me for this. But
that's all right, man. I'll watch the show.
I experienced disappointment a lot when I finally decided to get into a franchise that people love and have loved for years that I have ignored.
Fuller House.
And recently, one that I did that for was BioShock. Like 3 months ago, I was like, BioShock's $1 on Steam. Let me get that. Fucking hated it.
Why
really?
Hate
what? BioShock.
I can see how it was enjoyable like 8 years ago.
That's what
it has not
say.
Held
the
up.
The graphics don't. Is it the graphics? I mean, the gameplay was great.
It's not like the graphics being bad. It's just that
it
I think
package?
It's visually ugly and boring and repetitive, and I couldn't really tell what was going on all that much, and I just kind of hated it.
Through it because it really gets. I mean, BioShock Infinite is one of those.
Well, here's the thing.
Stunning.
People tell me the third one's great.
I mean, and I mean, you could pretty much play that one without having played the first two. But the first yeah. two,
that's
I love the first two.
So that's something I've learned with the PlayStation Now, like the streaming thing. Mm-hmm. You don't got to go back to one and two. Just
no.
go back to the newest title
yeah.
in a series, because as much as your friends like, no, you got to play one. It's so good. That's like firing up. I don't know, like.
Well,
an old lawnmower. You're like, this sucks.
The story
cuts grass.
Yeah. No lawn.
The story,
you're just sitting there
the story in BioShock 1 is great.
I couldn't tell what was happening
is.
Though.
No,
because
come on, it's
you
so
had
cool
to,
when the plane crashes and you're swimming in the
I,
fire.
I had like, no idea what was going on. To follow the story, you had to like find these little fucking like radio broadcasts
yeah.
and shit. I'm like, I don't have time for this. I'm trying to play a game.
It's true. It's not 1920. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But along what you were saying, I got the Nathan Drake collection, and all these years later, Uncharted 1 is
still
just not very good.
No.
Really?
No.
No, you just duck
it's
and
very
shoot.
Repetitive.
You
yeah.
duck and shoot
yeah.
as many
one
times
setting.
As you possibly can imagine.
Uncharted 2 and 3 and 4 are great, but the first one, it's all one setting. They were still figuring things out. They
That's
built
true.
On it later, but if you play the other ones and then go back to the first one, you're like, oh man, geez.
Well, you know what yeah, still well. Holds up weirdly enough is Ocarina of Time. Like it.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, yeah, but it's still, it was a game that came out like 20 years ago. Yeah.
I will argue that most of the top 10 games on a Nintendo system are still playable for across the whole, any mm-hmm. generation of Nintendo.
I agree with
yeah.
this.
Mario
and
Mario.
I would say you can't, like PlayStation 1, you can't even see the graphics. It looks like a sand art. Piece.
Yeah.
You're like, what am I
but
looking
at? But it's 3D.
Yeah, the worst
3D ants on your TV is what
yeah.
it looks like. I think the problem with some of these games, like now that we're getting into like everything CG is, you saw it with Injustice 2, you saw it with MKX, is they show you this trailer like, look at what Mortal Kombat's doing, like look what we're doing with Injustice 2. You're like, that's not the game. Like
yeah.
that's a
no,
CGI.
Those are cutscenes.
Not even like the Super Moon cutscenes.
Yes.
I'm like, Scorpion's not gonna shoot his spear out and get stuck in a tree and then not be able to yank it out and then Sub-Zero. I'm like, that's not the fucking
yeah.
game. Like, why are you showing
the
us
game.
Fake
well,
trailers?
Well, they're cinematic, but you look at the Blizzard cinematics, right? The Blizzard cinematics are amazing, but obviously the game, we
but
know
they,
at this point
dude,
that the
Blizzard
game has
cinematics
nothing to do with
is like getting drunk to fucking ugly person. That's what it is. It's like, this
that's
game
bull,
is unbearable.
Joke, but unrelated.
There's nothing fun to play.
Nothing to do.
It's like, enjoy this cinematic. Glug, glug, glug. You're like, oh, I'm drunk
have
enough to play this dumb
Overwatch
shit.
Have you played Overwatch yet?
Overwatch is the dumbest
It's because
game.
You don't know how to play it. That's
I know
why,
how to play it.
You don't know.
I'm not going to be support. All right, my favorite, this most disappointing game. Does that work? Favorite, most disappointing?
All of them.
more
Batman
words.
Batman Arkham Knight on the PC.
Oh, well, hold on.
Well, hold on. Let
you,
me tell you,
you
because.
You touch that hot stove?
Yes.
Just like, ah.
No, it makes sense. I know exactly where he's going with this.
I was like, I can't afford a PlayStation 4 right now. But I can afford to like mod my work computer, my like Mac Pro. I partitioned the drive, bought an SSD, ran boot camp. I got this Xbox controller. It was like a pro level controller. I was all jazzed. I couldn't wait to play this game.
You're like the guy who buys a Ferrari and then crashes it into a tree.
Yes, that's exactly.
Out of the dealership.
Yeah.
I clear my work schedule. I'm like, here we go. I was like, Batman. And they pulled it and I'm like, I'll play the bad version. I don't care if it's buggy. I'll play any version of this game. I can't wait for it. And
it was such a nightmare. That came out twice. It got
twice. Yeah, I couldn't even play it. They didn't release it.
I still haven't played it because of that. I love that series. Played all three of the games leading up to it. But now I'm just waiting for the console version, now that I have a console, to drop to like $15. And then I'll do it.
I love it, Elliot. This is your methods. You're like, we'll wait. You know,
I'm
we'll see if it's
I
good.
I am very stingy and miserly when it comes to paying for video games.
For me, I love those games. Even Origins, which people are like, that's dumb.
I'm
like, no,
Origins.
It was awesome. Yeah. I played that to death. I got every costume. I was like drunk, just buying skins. I was like, ooh, that's a cool bat suit. That's a cool bat suit. Don't tell my wife, and that's a cool bat suit.
I feel $40 like you were on eBay on a computer, you're buying real life bat suits that would fit you and Batman.
Yeah. There's no more room in the house. It's all bat suits.
Shut up, Alfred. I'm your fucking wife. Stop calling me Alfred.
God damn it, Alfred. But no, that game really, that struck a chord with me. I was like, I can't believe you guys are doing this.
But that's
I was
like,
just give me the bad version.
That's
of it. I'll play the bad
emotional
version.
Emotional Christmas morning letdown.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
That's some like you get over the hill,
yeah.
and it wasn't an oasis. It was a mirage. Like
yeah.
There is no game.
It's more right. Sand. Just sand.
Yeah.
I'm surprised no one said Duke Nukem. I mean, maybe that's just too obvious.
Was anyone still interested in that, though? By the time it came out, did anyone actually give a shit?
I mean, it was kind of the novelty of it. I feel like that's going to be Half-Life.
Everyone
as well.
Liked Duke Nukem because we were 12 years old, and he ripped off someone's head and shit down his neck.
And
that's why
pee.
We were like,
shoot.
Yeah, and boobs. But, like, no one was really excited for Duke Nukem.
But they did it. They made it happen.
I mean, they made it happen just, I think, to, like, fulfill a bet. Like, there was back-end points. But that's, like... Hearing about how Tila Tequila is a crazy bitch,
no.
And then you meet her and you're like, no, she's a crazy bitch.
Yeah. That's like the guy that says,
allegedly. Yeah. Allegedly, I learned it from your show.
That's the guy that says Van Wilder is my favorite movie. You're like, when you were 14, right?
Yeah.
He's like,
yeah.
No, it's my favorite movie still. And then you shoot him and you just bury the body.
I can't believe you managed to shoehorn a Tila Tequila reference
that's right.
here.
Good. Team Money, follow me on MySpace.
Inside job. Now it's time for a round of quick shots.
Oh,
let's
we're moving
take
on.
One and let's pass them down.
I got to stop you real quick because You've given me emotional Cooper as well. Coop, shout out to Cooper, wherever he is. The first X-Men on Genesis.
Oh.
I like getting
Space
him all
bonus.
Man, getting him all riled up. I'm like, Grandpa, tell me about the war, and then I run away.
Obviously, plenty of disappointing games have been released through the years, and gamers like to put them in their place. But we also know gamers can be an irrational and abrasive sort and
Never.
Can easily get carried away by hype. Have you guys read the comments? Or? Bottom line, which game got unfairly dragged through the mud and deserved a second chance? Chloe Dykstra, you're the gaming lady.
This is tough because I generally don't like the games that are generally not liked by. I pretty much
bandwagon,
agree.
Typical, yeah.
Yeah, I do. Sometimes I do jump on the bandwagon, but it's, I mean, there's a reason that people get really
if
frustrated
Smash
with the
Mouth
game.
Is the band.
If Smash Mouth is
if the wagon is attached to Smash Mouth, you'll
I don't know,
I would rather
I don't know
watch
if I jump
someone
on
play
band.
Smash Brothers than watch
I think... The first thought I had is Fallout 4, because even though it's generally it's grown to become more of a loved game when it
what
first
are you
came
talking,
out.
You mean the game that it's all people talked about for
it was,
8 years.
The reception when it first came out was not great. It was very tepid, sort of like the graphics were disappointing.
We did a million segments on that
game. It doesn't
game.
Matter.
Because I loved that game. But not everybody loved that game when it
How
first came out.
How did Nick and Phil feel? I kept looking down. I was like, when this shit over? Like,
yeah,
you're making like, your character, and you walk around like, hello.
Yeah, you guys.
I am PS3 graphics.
Not, I don't
you
fuck
guys
with
didn't
people.
Like it. People were not impressed by the graphics. Like, they felt like it was repetitive. They felt like it wasn't the same kind of Fallout that they loved. But when you actually really get into the game, then it's very immersive.
So it's
immersive.
An ugly person.
I still don't know what the game is about.
Yeah, it
I don't
is.
Know
it's
an ugly
whatever
yeah.
you want to get to know.
Yeah, that to me is it's too much.
So it's everyone. Match.com. Calling you out, Match.com.
You gotta go to OKCupid.
Don't sponsor us.
Rest in peace, Clan Ficky.
My answer is actually...
Clan Ficky! Sorry, that's an old...
That's our character.
That was our character on Fallout 4.
I have the same answer, because I love Fallout 4 and I hate it at the same time. I've had so many bugs and things right now. My save is so corrupted that I can't...
Yeah.
My own companions won't follow me around, but I'm just like, all right, I guess I'm going solo now because I've invested so much fucking time into it.
What about you, Phil?
Mine's a game called Vanquish. Sega published it. It was on PS3 and 360. Think of it as kind of like Gears of War dumbed down a little bit and on steroids, and it just-
Wait, hold on. Gears of War is Gears of War on steroids.
No, but it's like you have this crazy dash and you can like fly around the board.
That was
like
when I first knew
man.
I was old, when I watched my brother play Gears of War and I was like, I don't know what just happened. I don't know what I'm looking at.
You can move a lot faster and there's a lot of stuff and there's some quick time events, but it's like that and a lot of it got some decent reviews, but it looked super generic. And I was like, I remember when I first got a PS3, I was like, crap game. I was just looking for like demos, you know, like I was like, oh, what's this? I was like, ooh. It was it was really, really fun. And it's Gears wasn't always my jam because I just feel it's difficult. And the always in cover isn't fun to me. But Vanquish kind of was the antidote to that, where you can
you can do a dash, and like you're sliding with these like rockets, and then you can go into slow motion. So imagine Gears, but with you're in fast time. Motion with bullet time, and you're sliding on your knees,
that's
shooting.
Cool.
Where can I play this at?
Xbox 360 and PS3.
You could probably download it on the Xbox Live.
I'm gonna drop a new game for my pick. It's Mighty Number 9. I'm a big Mega Man fan.
Topical Tommy over here.
And I think it gets a bad rap. I really do. The game cost $3 million. They had this game, they made it, what, they developed it for 3 years. That's $1 million a year to have a staff of what, maybe five people to develop this game, come up with the art style. And everyone critiques it like as if it was a Gears of War or an Uncharted. And I'm like, that you can't even, these are billion-dollar titles, you know? Like, the major flagship titles are close to a bill.
No. I mean, like, yeah, they're probably like $50 million. They're like small movies.
No.
And this game was made for
fans. Halo costs like $300 million. Plus the marketing.
I defer to Inside Gaming.
I wish I knew about budgets.
Defer to Elliot.
Elliot.
Put him in LA. Games cost $59.99.
Sold! No, but so this game is...
No, here's the thing, but like, there are many games...
Where's the thing?
That, right here, there are many games that came out that did not cost $3 million to make that are a really fun, awesome experience.
That do
get compared to giant AAA titles and still hold up.
This game does hold up, though. I think the biggest problem is the graphics aren't as nice as
they could be. But graphics aren't that important.
But that's the biggest ping on it. And I don't know if you guys are Mega Man fans, if you play Mega Man, there's a dash technique in the game that most Mega Man fans, it takes some getting used to. So normally you just shoot a character, you spam them with your M Buster, and they blow up. But this time you shoot them, and then at a certain point, they glitch out, and then you dash through them. And so to work on that timing takes some getting used to.
But that seems like an evolution of the Mega Man formula.
I don't think it is. I think he went with a choice, and it's like you love it or hate it. But now that I'm used to it and I'm playing it, I mean, it's as difficult as I would want it to be. I'm not Ray Carcillo that beats Mega Man in 2 hours. Takes me 5 years. Well, that's all the time we have for today. Let's recap what we've learned. Elliot Dewberry wins Spacebar today for being the lone brave voice to take a shot against the first Bioshock game. Shut up, Cooper. It's an opinion that just happens to be shared by Spacebar producer Cooper Hagedorn. Hey, Elliot, we seem to have a lot in common. Want to come over to check out my thermos collection? Let me have my friends, Nick. You invite Elliot over? I didn't get an invite yet. We're best friends. I didn't get an invite. Ellie gets an invite. Chloe Dykstra publicly attacked Nick's knowledge of Overwatch on the show today. Phil Arrigo loses points for halting our momentum on Spacebar when he brought up the X-Men Genesis game just when we had all decided to move on with our lives. His punishment is he can't leave the studio today until he beats the game on hard difficulty.
Cool.
Today on Triggers, Nick Gregorio.
As for me, Nick Gregorio, where do we start? Maybe I couldn't afford to buy a PS4 because I spent too much time online getting schooled at Marvel vs. Capcom, you jerk. 3, by children in Mexico City. Also, the N64 actually launched in 1996, not 1997, like I said. Editor's note. Also, maybe if I took some acting lessons from Sean Ashmore, I can get some bigger roles, like the lead in Quantum Break, for example. That way, I can buy all the Batman skins I want and not worry about hiding it from my wife. My beautiful wife, who tolerates my crap.
Quantum Break yourself!
Cooper is feisty now. This is a whole new Cooper.
He'll say anything.
I like this guy.
Right. Yeah.
That's one of the things. I get to host the show if I say anything that they fucking like. Oh, guys, I hate to do this to you, but my memory card's full and it's last call. So, bottoms up, ass is out, space bar's closed. Ugh.